हेलो, आई एम प्रोफेसर राउत फ्रॉम केके बाग कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी। टुडे लेट्स लुक एट द राउंड्स लॉ एंड इट्स डेविएशन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो आइडियल एंड रियल सॉल्यूशंस। ऑल ऑफ यू नो आइडियल गैस इज वन इन विच देयर इज नो अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स। सिमिलरली द आइडियल सॉल्यूशन इज वन in which there is no change in the properties of component other than dilution when they mix to form solution. Means suppose you have 10 ml of solution A and 10 ml of solution B, then when you mix these both the solution, you will get the 20 ml of uniform solution, then it is ideal. If the volume of your solution get changes, then it is real solution. Then next part is no heat is evolved or absorbed during the mixing process. The final volume of solution represent the additive properties of individual constituents. That is no shrinkage or expansion occur when the substance are mixed. Means suppose when you you have two solutions, that is A and B, and both are mixed together, then what happen? There should not be evolution and absorption of heat, then it is ideal. Then there is no change of volume. Suppose you have these both of solution 10 ml with you, then ultimately after mixing your final volume should be 20, then it is ideal. There is no any shrinkage and expansion after mixing. That is the ideal solution. The constitutive properties like refractive index, surface tension and viscosity of solution are weighted average of properties of pure individual constituents. Means all these properties are average of these two type of the solutions when you mix it. Then mixing substance with similar properties form ideal solution, like when 100 ml of methanol mixed with 100 ml water, or sorry 100 ml ethanol, then the final volume of solution will be 200 ml. There is no change in the final volume. It should be additive value, 100 plus 100, it must be 200. And no heat absorbed or evolved during this mixing process, the solution is nearly ideal. Then when 100 ml sulfuric acid is mixed with 100 ml water, then what happened? The volume of solution is about 180 ml. Means it is not the additive value of individual component. And during the mixing, the considerable heat is evolved, the solution is said to be non-ideal or real. Okay, means during the during in second example, what happened? Your volume get vary and your evolution of an evolution of heat is there in second example. That's why it is real solution. Then we'll see the difference between ideal and real solution. Uniform distribution of attractive forces in between the molecule in case of ideal solution. Then unequal distribution of forces between the molecules are there in real solution. In case of ideal solution, there is no change in the properties of the component other than the dilution when they mix to form a solution. Okay, which properties? There is no evolution and absorption of heat. There is no change in the volume in case of ideal solution. In case of real solution, there is a change in the properties when they mix to form a solution. There might be changes in the volume, there might be changes in the heat. In case of ideal solution, heat is evolved and absorbed during the mixing process. In case of no heat is evolved and absorbed during the mixing and mixing process, but in case of real solution, heat is evolved and absorbed during the mixing process. Now, final volume of solution represent the additive property of individual constituents. Means 10 plus 10, it should be 20. But in case of real solution, there is a shrinkage or expansion of the system occur when substance are mixed. The constitutive properties of solution are weighted average of the properties of pure individual constituents. And vice versa case, in case of real solution. Example, 100 ml ethanol mixed with the methanol, then you will have the volume 200 ml and no heat absorbed and evolved during this mixing. In the second example of sulfuric acid and water, 100 ml of both, when you mix it, then you will get the volume 180 ml, means there is a reduction of 20 ml. And during this mixing, what happens? Considerable heat is evolved. This is the difference between ideal solution and real solution. Now we'll move to the next point, that is escaping tendency. When two bodies are in contact with each other, one is heated and other to higher temperature than other, then heat will flow from hotter to colder body until the body are in a thermal equilibrium. This process is termed as the escaping tendency. The hotter body has a greater escaping tendency until the temperature of both bodies is same. Okay, means hotter body is having ability to escape the heat from its body to the second body. Temperature is quantitative measure of escaping tendency of heat. Okay, means this escaping property of one substance is up to the equilibrium when both the substance or both the entity attain the equilibrium, then there is no heat is evolved from one substance or one body. Free energy is a quantitative measure of escaping tendency of substance undergoing physical and chemical transformation of pure substance. It is the molar free energy for solution and is a partial molar free energy. Then Raoult's law and its deviation. The vapor pressure of solution is partially important property because it serves as a quantitative expression of escaping tendency. In 1887, Raoult recognized that in an ideal solution, the partial vapor pressure of each volatile constituent is equal to vapor pressure of pure constituent multiplied by mole fraction in the solution. Means what? If you have two solution with you, that is A and B, okay, then the partial pressure of component A, that is PA, is equal to PA0 into XA. X is the mole fraction of component A. Then PB is equal to PB0 into XB. This is the PA and PB are the partial vapor pressure of constituent, that is XA and XB are mole fraction. Then PA0 and PB0 are vapor pressure of pure component of A and B respectively. Means vapor pressure of A constituent is equal to pure pressure of A into mole fraction, means how much amount of moles of that particular substance are present in the solution. Depending on that mole fraction, final vapor pressure is calculated. How can you calculate vapor pressure of PA is equal to mole fraction into vapor pressure of pure substance. Then vapor pressure of PB is equal to mole fraction of B into pure pressure of your component B. Now when you mix it, component A and B, then total pressure will be PA plus PB. And you can rearrange this equation by using above these two equation. P total is equal to XA into PA0, means mole fraction of A multiplied by vapor pressure of pure A plus mole fraction of B into vapor pressure of pure B. Now we'll see the example. Suppose this is the system is having only one component, or suppose this is the container of water. Okay, as water escape from this surface into the vapor, then it is the vapor pressure of pure water. Okay, in second example, water is mixed with the another solvent, then both the solvent molecule evaporate or create the vapor pressure on the surface of this liquid. Now how can you calculate this PB total, vapor pressure of this water and vapor pressure of the second solvent? And this will be this will give you the total pressure of this system. Okay, this is the example of individual solvent and this is the example of mixture. Now depending upon the mole fraction, you can calculate your final or the total pressure of the system. Suppose a mixture of ethylene chloride and benzene, okay, in a 40% to 60% of the volume by volume ratio, means 40 ml of ethylene chloride you have mixed with the 60 ml of benzene. Now how can you calculate the total pressure? Okay, individual vapor pressure is 236 for the ethylene chloride and 268 for the benzene. Now what happened? Then partial vapor pressure will be, all of you know, total P total is equal to PA plus PB, but PA is the multiplication of mole fraction of A into vapor pressure of A. Okay, here 40 is the volume, out of 100, 40 divided by 100, then it will become 0.4, that is the mole fraction of your ethylene chloride multiplied by its own pressure, pure pressure of only ethylene chloride, that is 236 plus 0.6 into mole fraction of, sorry, into vapor pressure of benzene, that is 268. Then by calculating this value you will get the final pressure, that is the P total of these two solvent will be 255.2 mm of Hg. Okay, this is the Raoult's law, means vapor pressure of mixture of two component in solvent form or in the solution form, in liquid form, will be depend on two things: pure pressure of its of individual component and its mole fraction. Vapor pressure composition curve of the binary system of benzene and ethylene chloride, we'll see. Three lines represent the partial pressure of ethylene oxide and benzene and the total pressure of solution as a function of mole fraction of constituent. Suppose here is the component A, 100% of component A, and it is having a vapor pressure 236. Now here is the component B, 100%. When you move along this line, you will get the composition of these two components or the two solvents. Then what happen? You can calculate the total pressure of any combination of these two solutions. This line represents the total vapor pressure. This line represents PA, that is the partial pressure of A is equal to mole fraction into pure pressure, vapor pressure. Then PB, that is the partial vapor pressure of B, is equal to pure vapor pressure of B into mole fraction of B. Clear about the Raoult's law? Now we'll move to the deviation of this Raoult's law. Raoult's law followed by the ideal solutions, but in case of real solution there is a deviation in the Raoult's law. Which type of the deviation we'll see? In ideal solution, attractive forces are assumed to be completely uniform. Then suppose the cohesive attraction of AA exceed the adhesive attraction of AB. Similarly, the adhesive attraction forces between AB may exceed between the force of attraction in AA and BB. This may occur even though the liquids are miscible in all proportion. Such a mixtures are called as real or non-ideal solution, and that is they do not adhere to the Raoult's law. Two types of the deviation from this Raoult's law are recognized, that is negative deviation and positive deviation. So what exactly this AA and AB? Suppose you have the two solutions or the two samples with you, that is A and B. A is having molecule A, then B sample is having molecules B. Then the AA molecule is having some force of attraction in between. When you mix it with B molecule, again there is a force of attraction between the molecule AB. Okay, then force of attraction between AA is known as the cohesive force of attraction, and force of attraction between AB is known as the adhesive force of attraction. Sometimes this cohesive force is higher, sometimes these adhesive forces, force of attraction between the molecule is higher and be high as compared to the cohesive force of attraction. Then what happen? Because of this variation in the molecules, in the force of attraction between the molecules, creates the positive and negative deviation in the Raoult's law. We'll see negative deviation first. Okay, if you see this diagram, negative deviation means the partial pressure, total pressure of these two components is less than the additive vapor pressure of individual. Okay, when adhesive attraction between the molecules of different species exceed than the cohesive attraction between like molecule, the vapor pressure of solution is less than the expected from Raoult's ideal solution law, and negative deviation occurs. If deviation is sufficiently great, the total pressure curve shows minimum. For example, chloroform and acetone. When A is diluted by B, that is chloroform is diluted by the acetone, reduction in vapor pressure of A would expected, but in case of negative deviation, liquid pairs, when A is diluted with B, reduction of vapor pressure of A occurs to great extent than expected. In case of chloroform acetone, the negative deviation is due to formation of hydrogen bond between them that results in reducing the escaping tendency of each constituent. Okay, you have the chloroform with you, you have the acetone with you. What is the reason behind this negative deviation? Adhesive attraction between the molecule of different species. Okay, different species means A and B. A molecule of chloroform and B molecule of acetone is having a more force of attraction than the force of attraction between the AA molecule and BB molecule. Okay, and why this force of attraction is high? Because of formation of hydrogen bond between them. When you mix this chloroform with acetone, there is a formation of hydrogen bond. Then what happened? Because of this hydrogen bond, molecule A of chloroform and B of acetone attract with each other. There is a more force of attraction in between them. That's why it decreases the escaping tendency of individual component in the system, and that's why the total vapor pressure get reduced, and total vapor pressure is not as predicted by the Raoult's law. This is the reason behind the negative deviation. Force of attraction between the different molecule is higher, that is the adhesive attraction is higher than the cohesive attraction between the like molecules. Now we'll move to the example, that is the chloroform form the hydrogen bond with the acetone, and because of this hydrogen bond, it decreases its escaping tendency and ultimately decreases the total vapor pressure. Now we'll move to the positive deviation. It is a vice versa case. Positive deviation means what? When adhesive attraction forces between the A and B is less than the cohesive attraction forces between pure constituent, B molecule reduces attraction between A molecule and A molecule corresponding reduces BB interaction. So the dissimilarities in polarities or internal pressure results in greater expansion of both AB molecules. The partial vapor pressure is greater than expected from Raoult's law and system said to be exhibit positive deviation. For example, benzene and ethanol, then carbon disulfide and acetone, then chloroform and ethanol. This Raoult's law not applicable for entire concentration range in non-ideal solution. Okay, what exactly this positive deviation? Total pressure of these two systems. Suppose this one is the A solution and this one is the B solution. The partial pressure of solution, pure pressure of solution A and pure pressure of solution B. When you mix it, you will not get the additive value. This value is more than the addition of the vapor pressure of each system. Means simply what? Instead of additive value, you are getting more vapor pressure. Why this vapor pressure is more? Because the additive forces of attraction between AB molecule, means molecules of system A and system B, having a less force of attraction in between them as compared to the cohesive attraction forces between the pure constituent, means as compared to the AA molecule, these AB molecule is having a less force of attraction. Okay, when you mix it A system with the B, there is a less force of attraction, that's why more escaping tendency. That's why when you combine the system A with the system B, there is a less force of attraction in between A and B. That's why it is more prone to the escaping tendency. That's why the total pressure is higher than predicted by the Raoult's law, and this is the positive deviation of the Raoult's law. Thank you.